the reminder for ourselves that the events of the Armageddon, what Allah wants for us is the station of faith. If you don't meditate, don't contemplate and don't try to open the heart, this just becomes a desert of immense difficulty. This way is based on contemplation, and they inspire within the heart that what is faith, what is Iman? فَمَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمَنُوا Though you who believe, more belief. Faith is not understood anymore, and trying to achieve it is not understood anymore. And the turuqs and the immense blessings of the Divine, the Presence for sending guidance. When He wants to guide the servant, He guides them to these realities so that they can achieve their faith, achieve and make their faith to be true. Allah says, infinite amount of belief has to be put upon the heart, and that belief has to become solid, rooted deep within the core of the being and the wujud of somebody, so that it becomes something that supports them and that they lean upon that reality to traverse the difficulty of this dunya and to achieve what Allah wants the servant to achieve of its paradise realities. That we are a spiritual being sent here for a physical experience. We're not sent for a spiritual experience because we're already spiritual. And this is from Prophet to the Holy Companions, that whatever the Messenger of Allah brought, the level of love, the level of belief that was attained was so immense that everything was real for them. Every event that Prophet talked about, explained, described, they were witnessing in their heart and in their being. The level of yaqeen, the level of immensity of belief.
As-salamu alaykum. We hope that you're enjoying the video inshaAllah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content inshaAllah. Share this video with your friends and loved ones. Subscribe to the channels and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
When awliya come into our life, this system, its understanding is lost. People thinking that if they describe, oh, the Shaykh described Armageddon is coming, Sayyidina Mahdi Salaam is coming. Oh look, it didn't happen, you were wrong. That wasn't the idea, because material people will confuse you. Say, look, these shaykhs are saying these things happened, this sickness happened, this we just described last night. Faith is very individual. Shaykh, give me a du'a that works. What do you mean du'a that works? Every du'a I make it works for me. If it don't work for you because your faith something's wrong. Not my du'a going to work for you. I'm not here to do your testing in your life, is the example. So last night we talked that no, it's I follow the teachings, I follow the advice the shaykh is giving, I give the support, I volunteer, I do everything the shaykh has given in the curriculum, and that's why they have all these different fingers on their hand, all these operations, because you have to be participating, you have to be volunteering, you have to be studying. So you can't have a shaykh who doesn't teach anything, what are you doing with him? There has to be an ilm and a knowledge that you're achieving as a result of all of those actions we described last night, that you're doing everything and you know how much you're doing it. And that's why they teach you, don't divert your heart into 20 different locations, because you can't be doing that to 3 people, to 4 people, to 5 people. So you won't build any faith. You can do it, continue, it's a free world. But you won't have any faith. Neither they will know you and you won't know them, because you deluded that reality. So what Allah wanted is be firm with one, accomplish something. So then when you keep the focus like racehorse, your blinders on that one, I study from that one. If I follow one who doesn't have a knowledge, doesn't have any way of activity, doesn't have any way of being of service and khidmat, you're wasting your time. Find the one that does. And then when you do, your whole focus is on that. And as a result, you're achieving your faith based on your actions. You study this material, or you just pretend like I'm listening on the couch and I go do my own thing. Well then I would be pretty scared when you come to read the du'as, they're probably not going to have much effect, because you don't really putting anything into it. These are just things that you're just repeating, alhamdulillah, it may give a little bit of a lightning, a little bit of things will be pushed away. But that's not what Allah wanted. Allah wanted that you followed them, you read from them, you studied with them, your heart connected to them. When they give you a du'a, you can shake the earth, because you believe and Allah grants your iman. Not the shaykh does grant iman. Shaykh grants the teaching here. I'm the one who you're going to practice with. When you have done all of that, you did, you committed, you learned, as a result Allah deposits muhabbat and love. That love is iman, because we said anyone who doesn't have love definitely didn't receive the gift of faith. Allah says, you're sincere, you're moving in that direction, I grant you love. And that's why the step of the tariqah is muhabbat al shaykh. The first step is to have the muhabbat and love, because that's the first gift Allah is going to give, is going to live a love into the heart like a light. And that love is now the opening of faith and iman. And then you keep the hudur, the presence. Is that I want to keep learning, I want to keep learning, I want to watch the video on a daily basis, I want to read, I want to absorb myself in the ocean of those knowledges, because those are Muhammadan haqqaiqs. As a result of that action, Allah gives more light. Then they begin to train, then make your tafakkur, make your contemplation, make your meditation. That light that Allah is depositing is a Muhammadan light in which you become attracted to all these awliya, to all that reality, to reach to the holy companions, to reach to the Ahlul Bayt. We don't understand who Allah is. Allah is love and muhabbat, I'm closer to you than your jugular vein. It's not a person. It's an emotion, it's a love and muhabbat. And Allah says, I'm the tear that runs from your eyes. For if I wasn't that tear, you would have a dead heart. The fact that I'm alive in your heart, every emotion is from me. The love you feel is from me. The tear that runs from you is from me. The breath you breathe from you is from me. You're like a bird flying in the breath of Allah with your belief. Allah's divinely breath, you're like a parande, you're a bird flying on that breath. So Iman is something we have to build. The shaykh comes to give the tests, give the facilities, give the ability, and then they begin to believe. So then they make the du'as, they should feel confident in their heart, Ya Rabbi, my love been checked, I've been participating, I'm reciting, of course it's going to work because that's what I believe is going to work. And Allah grant that to work inshaAllah. And that's how the lives of the shaykhs are, their belief like mountains that can't be understood. Then awliyaullah come and in their training keep teaching. Mawlana would say that Sayyidina Mahdi is coming, all these things are coming and everybody we ran out to buy boots because we said that it's going to be difficult times. How am I going to have and keep changing tennis shoes? We have our Mahdi boots and a duffel bag and I have my emergency supplies. Because when he said it, we believed it. The Armageddon, all the events of immense difficulty.
A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Marahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com.
Use your head, your head is your biggest problem. Your head is filled with shaitan. Your heart, fill it with Rahman. Don't think logically, what are you talking about, food going to finish. Now alhamdulillah Allah came and helped and made everybody realize last year food can actually finish. You saw the lines in America, food aplenty. Trucks vanished, stores empty from COVID. Allah says, but one shot I can empty all those stores. Of course you're going to believe when you have no food in your stomach. The belief was ahead of time to have prepared for that. So then he said that you're not going to see food. Then if you believe, so 10 of us are sitting there, 9 are saying, ah, what is he talking about? This is just entertaining. But all it takes is for one to believe that no food, stock up in my house. Mamati's kalam, I'm coming, I got my boots. I got thermal things in case the weather's cold. I have an extra blanket. I have some crackers for my children. I have all the things because he said it. I believed it and I worked on it and acted upon it. And then what happened? Others said, oh look, Imam Mahdi didn't come. And you turned to him and said, no, he did come, what are you talking about? You didn't see him? I said, no. If you believe, Allah open your heart and you sit with Sayyidina Mahdi. And whatever Mawlana Shaykh said, it happened because we witnessed Sayyidina Mahdi salam and sit in his association and he did come. And the firasa is so strong that when Mawlana Shaykh would say that this destruction coming, this destruction, when you believed it in your heart he showed it. So you see all these buildings, they're all on fire. So with their heart they can drive down and they see where is it destroyed. But they don't want to focus on that, They want to focus on, let me be with Sayyidina Mahdi salam. So anything they were teaching, it was not the material world understanding that, oh look, we're going to like test him and see if these things are happening. No, it was if you believed in what they taught, it happened for you. And I'm telling you, you can have a room of 500 people and Allah will send, because Allah's promised what? I give you what no ear has heard. Are you thinking this only happens in paradise? Or in every jama'ah somebody has an ability to hear something from their soul, something from angelic sounds, something from vibrations. Most of them hear waswases from shaitan. So everyone can hear. So Allah saying, I make you hear what nobody can hear, means each experience is individual. Don't think that everyone's going to hear, oh, the angels have arrived. No, the one next to you, right next to you can be hearing the angels and can be seeing in their heart Sayyidina Mahdi salam. And Allah opening their vision that your eyes see what nobody around you is seeing. Because I'm rewarding you with belief. When they recite, their shaykhs appear. When they recite for Mawlana Shah Naqshband, they're sitting in association in the presence of Mawlana Shah Naqshband and all the 40 grand shaykhs of the tariqah. But physical people are saying, where did this happen? I just saw like 5 guys. They missed completely the concept of faith. Faith was not something physical, faith was not anything to do with the physical, you use the physical to achieve the malakut and the world of light. And that's what the purpose of the shaykhs were, to tell you disaster coming, use your physical resources, your money, your time, prepare for disaster. As a result, Allah granted the light of faith into the heart. So you used what Allah gave you of your material, and that's when Ayatul Kareem Allah say, we took from them their dunya and we gave to them in exchange their akhirah. This is not about a collective vision where we're all going to do it and we're all going to see something. Everyone has just one grave and Allah wants to know, are you ready for your grave? That you're not bringing 10 people with you in the grave, where all my partners, where all the people were supposed to help. Is your grave is just you. So then our life, especially with the turuqs, is every isharat that they're giving, every teaching that they're giving, Allah's watching to see how you act upon it, how you do it, how you implement it. As a sign of your faith. And it wasn't for material people to come back and criticize them, because that's what shaitan wants, come back and say, look, the tariqah was like this and like this and they said so many things and they didn't happen. Oh, those are hizb shaitan. Shaitan never going to see anything and not going to achieve anything in paradise. But if Allah wants to open for His servant paradise on this earth, it's a whole different game. And whatever happened in our life of our testing and difficulties, the only regret we have is we didn't do more with the time that we had with our shaykh. And what we could have achieved more of those realities is the only regret. Because you don't know how much time you have with that reality, it doesn't just stay forever. Something comes and then it goes, and what you achieve from it, what you can get from it, what you build of yourself had nothing to do with the shaykh but had to do with your belief. Is coming, going, nothing to do with you, it's about your belief and what you achieve from it. Whatever I followed, whatever I put in, whatever I contributed, whatever I did for my faith. My shaykh is where he is, conditioned he is, but what was open for me of my faith from Allah from the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad and awliyaullah, alhamdulillah. I just wish I would have done more with my youth. So means then, this is not the material people coming and pointing, what's like that, what's like that. No, no, this is becoming much more complicated, because everybody on earth is now saying, take this, take that, take this, take that. Which one of those are poisonous? And at the same time, if you don't have belief, not the poison to hurt you and to be protected from every type of difficulty, it requires immense belief that I was supposed to use my dunya to make my faith real. Whatever we did with the shaykhs, they said, well, we need to do that, we're first on it. We need to put this out, we're first to do it on. Everything he was saying, the world's gonna collapse, get food, we went and got all the food we could possibly get. And that's all that was important. Allah tested, whose world is going to end when that clock hits that 12? Anyone who prepared and prepared and thought, definitely it's ending, definitely it's ending, and they're with these turuqs, Allah ended it. But for everyone else, it continued going. And they were like critical, watch this, what happened was like that. But for Ahlul Basira and those whom were studying to be of that reality, their world ended and Allah opened what He wanted to open. So at every moment, these tests, these isharats, these guidances are not for the physical ears and physical eyes, and not for all your family and friends to come and judge and give you all sorts of waswases. That's why now everything is multiplied. Every waswas, do this, take that. What you're doing to block your faith, that none of this is real, none of that is that. Well, because burning people want other people to be burning too. The oven's lonely. Those whom have faith, and especially towards last days, is like holding fire in their hands. Why? Because they want to keep the belief, but not only spiritual waswas, physical waswasas are now coming from every direction, do this, do this, do this. And that's the difficulty. But everything they're teaching is based on action. When the person takes an action towards the teaching, towards it, don't worry about if the event came, spiritually Allah will make it to come. Because the interest is to be with Sayyidina Mahdi salam in the spiritual world. We don't need to see burning buildings and be pleased with that. We needed to believe in these things and Allah make it, so sit in their company, look at the tajalli, feel the tajalli and the grace of Allah's diwan and the associations of heavenly souls. We pray that Allah open more and more understanding. This is something that is something through the tongue, but requires to contemplate, and it's not something that the mind can understand and somebody next to you say, oh look, none of these things happened, they all happened. And Allah opened everything He wanted to open for those whom believe. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com
is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate. Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Marahmidi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com. Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android.